everyone, I am Anthony from ComicsHeatingUp.net. I'm doing the new comic spec review video for June 13th, 2018. Can't believe the year is going by so fast and we're already talking about the middle of June books. Lots of good books this week, so let's get things started. Killer Bee covers this week up for DC Comics. First up is Flash 48 with a Francisco Mattina cover. Not much to say about Mattina. He is a fan favorite. These are beautiful covers and I'm putting away a set of each. Same thing goes for Suicide Squad number 43, which also is a variant by Francisco Mattina. This is by far my favorite of the two, just love the skulls of the characters. DC's potential spec hit this week is Titan Special number 1. Rumor has it that Crush, the daughter of Lobo, could be appearing this issue. If that's true, this one could be well chased after. We will have the definitive news on it Tuesday night, so be sure to check out ComicsHeatingUp.net for all the details. Bloodstrike, the Rob Liefeld book, returns with Bloodstrike number 0. Normally I wouldn't care, but it has art by Michelle Fifay, the incredible indie artist behind Copra. Copra is an amazing book and I love the style, so I will be picking one of these up. Magic Order number 1 is out and features the first comic book appearance of the characters and titles of Mark Millar's new upcoming Netflix TV show. Big print run guaranteed on this. Midtown is sold out of their B and C covers, so if you see the B or C cover, you might want to grab one. Image has a couple of new books out, starting with Proxima Centauri number 1 and Stellar number 1. Of these two, Stellar number 1 looks more promising. This is based off a Robert Kirkman pilot series book from a bunch of years back, and this looks pretty cool. Weatherman number 1 is another new Image book out this week, which features a 1 in 25 Medio Scalaria cover that is being sought after. If you can find it cheap, definitely flip it. Deadpool gets another new series with Deadpool Assassin number 1. There's a regular Mark Bagley cover that's pretty cool, but there's also a variant by Bill Sienkiewicz. 50-50 split on these covers. Grab the one that you like. An all-new Thor starts starring the Odin son himself. Thor Volume 5 number 1 has a bunch of different covers, with some highlights being the Christian Ward variant, the Esad Ribic variant, and the remastered Jack Kirby color and black and white covers. Venom number 2 has the potential to be big if the God of the Symbiote character gets its first full appearance or not. Donny Cates is known for surprises, so we have to see here. We'll have the full news at ComicsHeatingUp.net this week. Three covers on this, including the regular The Mike Del Mundo Young Guns cover, and a pretty awesome Sam Keith cover. It's a big week for indies. Filbert Factor number 1 is a really interesting one because the publisher American Mythology keeps talking about how this book was rejected for Free Comic Book Day. Not sure why it was rejected. This book is being touted as one of the most ridiculous things that you will see this year. Walk Through Hell number 2 is out this week and picks up where the intensity of number 1 ended off. Looking forward to seeing where this Garth Ennis story goes. Aftershock has the potential of a really great book on their hands here. By Night number 1 is from Boom Comics. It's a story about coming home, discovering identity, and accidentally smashing a hole into another dimension. Aspiring documentarian and an actual chemistry major, Jane has recently reunited with her former best friend Heather, amateur urban explorer, when a trip to an abandoned industrial building leads them to another world. Their plan begins to unfold, create a documentary about the world, and become filthy, filthy rich. The other side of the portal is filled with monsters, magic, and the chance of a whole new life, though. Scout Comics gives us Zinnabar number 1. This was previewed in the Free Comic Book Day, The Mall book. 20 years ago, dragons returned to the Earth and laid waste to human civilization. In the event, the surviving humans named Zinnabar, Claire, then a young girl, lost her parents to the devastating force of these primal creatures. Today, she's hell-bent on avenging the death of her family. Good-looking book. I'm a big fan of Scout books, so I'm really looking forward to this one. And that's it for us this week. Let us know what you think. Remember to give us this video a thumbs up, and remember to like the channel if you haven't done so. Please give us a follow. This channel keeps getting bigger and bigger, and we really appreciate it. Thank you for watching. We'll see you next week.